Hello, everyone. Welcome back. Thank you so much for joining us today. My name is Darcy.
And I'm Ramari.
And this is Texas City Tells. On today's episode, we have Fernando with Tello's Collision. Thank you so much for joining us.
Howdy.
Thank you. Thanks for having me on. That's
really awesome. Can you tell our listeners what happens at Tello's Collision?
At Tello's Collision, we do automotive repairs whenever you wreck your car, or fender benders, big collisions, or you want to refresh your paint, you want to make your car, you know, beautiful again. That's the type of work that we do.
Okay.
Okay. So it's not like a tire shop if I
needed air.
Yeah,
if you needed air, you need to go like to one of the local tire shops here in town.
Got it.
They'd be able to take care of you over there. I mean, we could definitely put air in your tire if you need be, but if you want specific, you know, questions right. about tires, I'd go to a tire shop for that.
Understood.
And how long have you been in business?
So our shop has been in business for 46 years.
Wow.
Yeah, a long time. My father and my uncle started the business back in 76.
Okay.
And but I grew up in the shop. I can't remember a time that I wasn't either at the shop, either playing around when I was little or actually working or, you know, running around the shop. So I've had a lot of experience.
I can relate. My dad owns Domac Incorporated here in town. And so Perry O'Brien. And we grew up same thing. He'd pick us up from school and we'd go do our homework in the shop and run around on the yard, all that.
That's
so
it. That's
definitely
exactly,
can relate.
That's exactly how it was. Definitely.
My mom used to be like a museum curator for an air museum
back when we
lived in California. So I grew up like in an airplane museum.
Wow, that is awesome. Just hanging out in the planes, pretending like you're flying.
Just getting lost.
Imagine those.
She'd be like, why are y'all
games?
On the tarmac? We didn't know.
Wow.
Just like, man. Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
That's neat.
So has your family business always been in Texas City?
Yes. So it used to be over on Texas Avenue over by Matthew's Tire. They're still over there. Yeah, but we started over there. And then about 20 years ago, my dad bought the new location over on the Loop. So we've been there about 20-something years now.
And whereabouts on the Loop are you?
So it's on, the address is 2510 24th. I guess we'd be in between Church's Chicken and the Valero across the street.
Right.
Kind of in that block right there.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know exactly where you're at.
Yep. That's kind of the two points that I always deal with.
I'm always a landmark kind of person when I'm doing directions.
Yeah, definitely.
It's by Church's. Okay, got it.
Tell me where it's by and I know.
Don't tell me north, south, east, west because...
Yeah, it's not going to help you.
I get that.
Are you guys doing construction?
So we're going to be expanding here. I'm hoping to be breaking ground here by the end of the year. So we're definitely looking to expand.
Wonderful.
Business has been great. Our customers are amazing. So, yeah, we definitely want to make our facility bigger to facilitate all of our customers and all the extra work that we're taking on here lately.
That's great.
Yep.
That's great to hear.
Yep, awesome. Yeah, we love that. We love that we're able to do that here. So,
Go ahead. I was going to ask if you're from Texas City.
Oh, yes. Yeah, my wife and I both are from Texas City. Of course, you had her on last week, Dr. Tello. We pretty much raised each other. We met in junior high.
That's so sweet.
Yeah, we met in junior high, and we started dating the summer between my before my freshman year. So. We're both from Texas City, born and raised. We have our kids here in Texas City. One of them's in high school now, and the other one's over at Levi Fry.
Okay.
Yeah, so we're both from here, and we love it here.
Yes.
Yeah, we love Texas City.
Good.
Yeah.
Because we love having you guys.
Yeah, we definitely like it. I mean, we're involved in all kinds of things. We're she's big in the Boy Scouts, and I help out with that as well, but she's a big proponent for the Boy Scouts, and I am too, to try to get the boys to – you know, participate in other things. So, yeah, we love that.
I wish that my brothers had done Boy Scouts because I feel like maybe I would have been able to tag along. I've never been camping.
Yeah.
Well, and I really want to.
Now there's girls in Girl Scouts now, so that's
pretty good. Do they go camping?
Yeah. Okay. Well, when I did Girl Scouts 1 year, but I quit because my troop didn't sell cookies. So I was like, what? What am I doing here? Yeah. But we got to go camping and we got to spend the night at the zoo. It was so much fun.
Yes.
It was real cool.
Okay.
Yes. We stayed in the reptile house.
I
know. You wouldn't be.
No, absolutely not.
I thought it was the coolest thing.
Reptile, no.
Yeah.
I'm not going.
Yeah. Oh, it was fun.
Send me home.
Exactly. Well, what do you think camping is going to be like, Goof?
Yeah. So maybe I don't need to do that. I'm just going to scratch it off my mind.
There's certain campouts you can be like, I'll go to that one, but not that one.
Glamping. Okay. That's for you. That's for you.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely.
Indeed. Okay, so segue. I have a random question.
Okay.
And I know you said you do paint and body work. Mm-hmm. Let's say I was crafting at home, right, and I had some gold spray paint, and I spray painted it really close to my vehicle, and now I have a gold-flecked vehicle.
Oh, so you got some overspray.
Yes. Any suggestions? Just take it to you and get a whole new color?
Well, you can change the color if you'd like. That'd be very expensive, but
it's black.
Just to be able to do that. No, there's you can use a clay bar to try to take that off, and there's some compounds you can use to get it off. It's not the end of the world. It's easy. It's an easy fix. Yeah, it's an easy fix.
Good to know.
We get some pretty serious cases of overspray from industrial stuff.
Oh, man.
Somebody's painting their house and it lands all over the car. So
yeah,
a spray can is not too bad.
Yeah, see? It's not too bad. Good to know. I didn't know that.
Definitely.
Good question. We'll
definitely help you out with that.
Yeah. I'm walking around looking like ombre or something.
Oh, you got the ombre do.
You got to look real close at my car. But anyways, I was like, I'm going to ask him.
Yeah, no, that could definitely be fixed.
I love watching those videos where they paint trucks and cars and all that. It's soothing.
It is soothing, yeah. Actually, sometimes I'll go into the paint booth and watch the guys paint. Yeah. And I'm just like, you know, I'll be in there just hanging out because it's just, I love it, you know.
How big is your crew? How many people do you have?
So right now we have 5, 2 body men, a painter, a helper. I have Rosie. She's in the front office. If you call, she's going to want to be the answer to the phone. She does most of the dealings with the insurance companies and customers and myself, and my father's still there.
Okay.
He comes and goes, but for the most part, he's still there. He's still there, yeah. Definitely still part of the business.
That's good. Awesome.
Yeah.
What are the hours at Tello's Collision?
So we're there from 8 to 5. If for some reason a customer needs to come in or earlier than that, well, you know, they can just call us and then we'll be like, okay, we'll meet you there early or stay late if need be. But 8 to 5 on Monday through Friday is our schedule. Yeah, but, I mean, you can drive by there on a Saturday and we're out there because sometimes we're trying to catch up on work or stuff like that. So if we're there and you see us, you know, stop on by. We'll definitely take care of you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Have you always wanted to work in this industry?
So, I mean, I guess growing up in it, I've always loved being around cars. Whenever I was growing up, my dad always had a cool car, and like, it was always fixed up pretty neat, you know. So it was always something that I was kind of grew up passionate about, and I definitely love what I do. So it's something that I do because I love it, definitely. Good.
That's good. My dad said it's hard to kind of find mechanics in this day and age, so.
Yes.
Sticking with that skill set and things like that, that's very important.
Yes, definitely. And then right now, the technology that's out in these vehicles is just, it's amazing. You almost got to be a computer whiz. Not to say that I'm a computer whiz now, but we have companies that we partner with that help us with all of the technology that's coming out nowadays. That you going back in the day, you would go into a shop and there would just be hammers and dollies and that's all that you would see.
Mm-hmm.
And now you see computers, you see computerized 3D measuring machines, you see lasers, you see, if somebody were to walk into a shop now from back in the day, they'd be like, what is this?
What's happening?
Yeah.
You know, what's going on? It's just wild, the technology that's in these vehicles nowadays.
Would you say that's one of the problems you have facing your industry?
Definitely finding technicians that are wanting to keep up with the technology that's coming through, definitely. That is a major issue, finding people that want to learn and want to keep up with that. It's right now just a matter of staying on top of all the new stuff that's coming out every day. Just like a phone, you get a phone right now, and then next month they're wanting to sell you something new.
Right.
Yeah.
Because that's the way the technology is now in these vehicles.
Right.
Yeah.
So I know that you guys are planning to expand. What is your ultimate goal for Tello's Collision?
The ultimate goal, I guess, would be to get to a point to where we're able to get a customer's vehicle in and get it out as soon as possible. Right now, the backlog in some of the shops, not just at our shop, at other shops as well, it's pretty wild right now, especially with actually we're still feeling some of the effects of COVID because of
the supply chain.
It's hard to get parts nowadays. It's getting a little bit better, but still the getting parts and getting cars in and out has kind of been the difficult part. So I guess getting the shop to where we can get able to get cars in and out faster and safer for our customers. Yeah.
Okay.
I was checking out the logo on your shirt. It's pretty legit. Do y'all only do cars? Can you, if I needed like something else painted?
No, we actually do golf carts. We do a lot of
what?
Golf carts.
Oh, that's smart. That's smart.
Polaris's, motorcycles, just about anything that you can drive on the road that you want painted, we can handle. Yeah, we do. We do a lot of stuff like that. And or somebody will paint their truck and they'll be like, I want my motorcycle to match this, or I want, you know, something else that I tow behind it to match it. So
yeah,
it's nothing for us to see one thing. We paint two or three things for the same customer to match the vehicle.
So you said your dad always had a cool car growing up. Do you have one?
Yeah.
Do you have like your own little special hot rod or fancy truck?
I actually have one project that we're working on. I just haven't had very much time to actually work on it. It seems like I'm working on everybody else's stuff besides mine.
Man.
Yeah, right. Yeah. And I have a little sports car that I drive that coordinate things I drive around too fast in. But
well, that's what they're
that's
for.
What they're
that's
for.
What they're for,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right.
How especially cool. If the top comes down.
It has a sunroof. It has a sunroof,
okay.
So that makes it
see?
That makes it all right, especially on a Sunday when you're out driving too fast.
Nice. I know a big thing that I've seen lately are like slingshots. Has anyone ever brought one into your
shop? We've actually painted a few of those.
Okay.
Like I said, somebody, the last one that we did, a customer was a big Dallas Cowboys fan. So, yeah, we did all the Dallas Cowboy theme on it, stars and all of that. So
that's cool.
It was actually pretty neat. He had a truck that's already kind of the same way. So,
those fans are hardcore.
Yes, definitely.
It's Texas, I guess.
Yeah, they go all out.
Yes.
His garage is probably.
Oh, I'm sure. His
decked.
Whole house, I think, is decked out in Dallas Cowboys.
Yeah.
So, yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Do you guys get a lot of like repeat customers or ones that you've had generation after generation?
Yes, definitely. Since my dad and my uncle started this business 45 years ago. Definitely, we have third generation customers coming to us now.
That's wonderful.
The grandkids are now coming to us. So yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm. I would say that's probably about 80% of our customers are repeat customers and word of mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely. Yeah.
Do you guys have a social media presence?
So. We do Facebook, and I have an Instagram, but I post a little bit on that too. But in fact, that's really most of our advertising is through Facebook and stuff like that. Pictures. I mean, it's just social media has been a big proponent for us to grow. So sometimes we'll put a few pictures of cars that we repaired on there, and then it's like the next week our phone's blowing up. Everybody wants to bring their cars in, and it's like, whoa, we can schedule you indefinitely. So.
Man, record some of those painting videos. I'd watch all of those.
Your video was just so soothing.
Man, this suck you in.
Yes, definitely.
The start to finish, that whole process.
Yes, it is. It is.
Is
really
amazing.
Neat. It is really neat.
And
I think it's all.
I feel like I
want to
try it too.
Oh, that'd be cool.
I feel like I want to try it. I think I could have a steady hand, but I don't know the whole.
Definitely.
You know,
I mean, whenever I was learning, it was funny.
You can do it too.
Oh yes, yes I. I learned from the bottom up. I started at the shop sweeping, started sanding, painting. I do all of it. Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah, my dad was told, like,
oh yeah,
if you're gonna be the boss one day, you gotta learn it all.
From A to Z.
You got time to lean. You got time to clean.
That is it. That is exactly right.
So if you ever have an internship program, just look out for her application.
I'll be there.
All the answers. I love that. That's pretty good. If you have time to lean, that's pretty
good. If you got time to lean, you got time to clean.
Dr. Tello told us when she was here that she's gotten into TikTok.
Oh,
has
yes.
she drug
she,
you into
she's
any videos
me
yet?
Into a couple of them, yeah.
Okay.
Made you hold the phone at least.
Oh yes, definitely. I've gotten a lot of that. Here, hold this and do this and let's redo that. And I'm like,
up
right.
high too.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I got to get the angles right.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Yeah, no, she's actually done one for our shop the other day. She was off, and she was over there. She's like, all right, let's do this one. I'm like, okay, so now that one's on our Facebook now too.
That's nice. Good though. It's good they are supportive.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh yeah. No, that's a big deal. She loves TikToks.
Do you feel like with your business, you've gotten a lot of family and friend support?
Oh yeah, no, definitely. All of my family members from my sisters, of course, and my cousins, and we have a big family, so they're always supportive and sending their friends, and that means a lot whenever your friends and family are sending their best friends. So, mm-hmm. you know, that means a lot to them.
Right.
But they're definitely supportive of our business, yeah. Yeah, because especially since we've been around for so long, they know that we'll take care of them.
Yeah. That's cool that your sisters come to you. My brothers probably feel the same because my dad was very big on teaching them how to fix cars.
Oh, yeah.
And so I call them for everything. Everything.
Yeah, no, she calls me every once in a while. She's like, hey, you know, this is doing that, and this doesn't work. And I'm like, well, try this, and you're just going to have to bring it down. It's right. easier for just to let me look at yeah. it.
Right.
You know, otherwise I'd be here all day trying to explain.
I'm always like, my car's making this kind of noise, and like trying to explain it. My dad's like, yeah, I don't even know what you're saying.
Yeah, I don't know what you're saying.
Just bring it. Yeah, just bring it in.
Can you do that again?
Right, one more time. Here it goes. Yeah. Only when I turn. Yeah, just a mess. So we got to ask the last female person that we had on our show, mm-hmm. what was the last thing she did for self-care? What was the last thing you did for self-care?
Self-care, jeez.
Something just for Fernando.
That's a tough one.
I know.
What it's like now with kids, that we're doing everything that I do, I want to do it for them. You know,
well,
so
yeah.
it's like, well, I mean, I like to go. My boys are involved in skeet shooting and stuff like that.
Okay.
So that I like to do that, too, you know, just to get away from things, you know, and take the pressure off of stuff.
That's a lot of fun.
Yes, we love to go do that. So I guess if self-care, that's kind of a mental thing.
That counts.
You know, if you get off and blow off some steam, that's kind of.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's mm-hmm. I would say that. Yeah, definitely.
That's a good answer.
Yeah.
Can you get to 25?
You know, no, I'm not even.
I can't.
My son is really good.
That's good.
Yeah, he's there. He's shooting 25s all the time.
Man.
So it's like, come on, dude. Give me a chance.
The highest I got was 16.
Oh, that's pretty good.
I know.
That's pretty
good.
So
25 is a perfect score.
Yes.
When you're shooting skeet. And the highest I got was 16. But my dad and my brother, they can.
Crack shots.
Yeah, 25s all the time, 24s. And then here I'm like, I got a 16. Well, before that was like a 9 or maybe a 4. You never know.
Yeah, no. I love doing that.
It's a good time.
I've never
You'd have
played
fun.
It a
yes.
day in my life. I've seen people play
shooting.
It.
Shooting.
Yeah, but I've never tried.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool.
But
good answer.
I know that like our Texas City shooting range, don't they have
mm-hmm.
Yeah, and okay. In fact, my son is on the Texas City shooting team.
Is he good?
And so he shoots with them, and then he's also on another club team that he shoots with too.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's neat.
Cool.
Yeah.
So what does a typical work day look like for you?
So I would say, like, say today, Monday mornings, they're always, you get there. I usually have a customer or two waiting from something that happened over the weekend, you know,
mm-hmm.
fender bender or my light's not working. Can you get this to work, you know?
Yeah.
Or somebody's, I locked the keys in the car and I did this trying to get into it.
Yeah.
That sounds you like
know.
Me.
Yeah. So Monday mornings are usually like that. And, of course, receiving customers that are already scheduled for the week. Of course, phone calls with insurance companies and that. And heck, by then it's lunchtime.
Yeah.
And after that, we're probably ordering parts or making sure that we've received everything or everything that's been ordered has come in. And that's about the end. By the time I'm looking up, it's the end of the day.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know, but whenever we're not at the shop, we're I'm going with Courtney to the Rotary Club meetings, we just got involved again with the chamber, so we've gone to a few of their events whenever they have something after work. So
wonderful.
That's you know, definitely what we stay involved with.
Yeah,
I know Christmas is right around the corner.
Mm-hmm.
Do y'all offer any kind of specials?
Well, we actually haven't really looked at that yet, but we need to get something together for some, because at Christmas time. Nowadays, with as much as everything has cost and vehicles, are you know definitely can I get some work done to my car for the holiday? You know,
right.
So definitely we're gonna look at something like that to have give our customers something to maybe buy for their children or their family member.
Whoever,
Dad, if you're listening,
a special someone.
I want some work on my car. Can you help me out? You know?
Right.
But yeah, definitely.
Do y'all sell any car accessories?
No, we don't.
Not
we don't
really?
Do many accessories. No, we will buy them for say if some a car comes in that has some damage
mm-hmm.
to an accessory, we will buy that and put it on. But
right.
we don't specialize in accessories. No. Yeah.
Okay, I have one more random question.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you have a favorite car show that you watch? Or because you do that all the time, you're like, I want to watch something else.
Well, yeah, I get that a lot. Actually, I have some people that ask me, like, how come you don't have a big hot rod and this and that? I'm like, I work on cars all day long. Right. I don't want to do it when I'm at home, too.
Yes, that makes sense.
But, you know, I still do love watching cars. I do like watching that Barrett Jackson show, just seeing what cars are selling for nowadays. Mm-hmm. And some of the cars that come through, they're amazing. You know, yeah. The quality of some of those cars is neat. Yeah, definitely. That Barrett Jackson is probably one of my favorite ones.
Man, I'm trying to think of the one that we watched, my husband and I watched, and I can't think of it. Shoot.
The last car show I probably ever watched was like Pimp My Ride.
I was like, are you going to say it, Pimp My Ride?
Yeah, I was like a teenager. I just knew that I was going to have a fish tank like floating through the center console of my car.
There was some random stuff in there.
Yeah.
Well, what I love about those shows is like, they condense everything down and like they completely restore a car in 30 minutes. And I'm like,
right.
Sometimes it takes months, even years to do some of those cars, right. You know, but they condense it down pretty quick. And I'm like, wow, that's I wish that my cars could come up that fast, you know?
Heck yeah.
But yeah. There was one girl who had like I guess she was like a business person that was very busy. And so I think they put like a steamer rack and some stuff in her car so that she could like iron her clothes. I just knew that I was going to have that in my trunk.
Yes.
Oh, that'd be pretty neat. Yeah, drive your car off and now it's got all these accessories.
Yeah, thank God for growth.
That show was crazy.
I still
watched it, though. It was funny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, there's some show that we watch and the guy's in Houston and I can't think of his name, but oh well, doesn't matter.
He did all that type of custom work as well?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I have to look that up.
Nothing crazy like a steamer inside. Yeah. It's like that, like the you know the fancy radio or the giant speakers or the whatever you want it to do.
Yeah, all the customized stuff, drop down real low and all that. Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, can you tell our listeners again where you're located and how to find you on social media?
Sure. So our address is 2510 24th Street North in Texas City. Like I said, it's in between churches and the Valero on the loop. We are on Facebook, Tello's Collision, and our website is telloscollision.com.
Perfect.
Excellent.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thanks for having
we
us.
We love having you in Texas City, and we are very happy that you guys have continued your support of our community.
Thank you. We love it here. We'll always be here to support our town for sure.
Yes.
Yay.
Thank you to Mr. Fernando with Tello's Collision. Thank you to the City of Texas City for sponsoring this podcast. If you know someone that is an entrepreneur or doing amazing work in Texas City, we ask that you drop their names as a recommendation inside of the comments. You can catch a new episode of Texas City Tales every Wednesday on the City Facebook page, website, YouTube page, and anywhere podcasts are streamed. Thanks for watching.
Bye.